Welcome to Before You Brew. Today I'm going to be talking about Grolnok, the omnivore. This is a series designed to give you all the information you need before you brew a commander. This includes archetypes, budget, power level, helpful resources, and more. Grolnok, the omnivore is 2 green-blue for a legendary creature frog. Whenever a frog you control attacks, mill 3 cards. Whenever a permanent card is put into your graveyard from your library, exile it with a croak counter on it. You may play lands and cast spells from among cards you own in exile with croak counters on them, and it's a 3/3. There are 2 main archetypes you can play with Grolnok: Frog Tribal and Self Mill. You can also play with a combination of these. Frog Tribal is one of the first thoughts because besides Morophon, there's not really any other options for Frog Tribal commanders. Frogs are mostly unsupported, and there are only 32 frogs in Magic, and only 23 of those are in Simic. This lack of support combined with the fact that most of these frogs are unplayable means that we need to lean a lot on changeling and choose a creature type effect. This search shows all these effects within our color identity. Milling and exiling our library from our attacking frogs will allow us to draw cards since we can play lands and cast spells from exile with croak counters. Adding in a large quantity of ramp just lets you keep playing more and more cards. Our mill is based on attacking, and that makes our deck relatively fragile to board wipes. We also need to have our commander out to play lands and cast spells, therefore having a large amount of protection in the deck is important. We can recast Grolnok and get those spells that we've exiled earlier, but that can really slow us down. All the important aspects of this deck are replaceable with more budget versions, so I could see a $50 US deck working in Battlecruiser, or a $100 US deck in low power. For mid, you need more of the upgrades and staples, but I could see it for about $250 US. And I don't think a Frog Tribal deck is viable in high power. These are all estimates, and it's almost certainly possible to make cheaper or better decks than what I've guessed, but these will be roughly accurate to the average Grolnok decks in those price ranges. The next biggest archetype is self-mill. Grolnok will take all the cards milled from our library and exile them with croak counters. So if Grolnok is on the field, we can cast spells and play lands from those exiled cards. So any card that mills us is almost as good as drawing that many cards. It's also unique from other mill decks for 2 main reasons. The first is that our graveyard doesn't fill up. Instead, our cards are exiled. This means we can't take advantage of typical graveyard shenanigans, but it also means that our opponents can't mess with our plan by using graveyard removal. The second difference is that we don't have black. All the reanimation and powerful mill cards of black are gone. We can only use the cards we draw if we have Grolnok out, so running sufficient protection is important. It's also important to recognize that milling cards before we get Grolnok out won't actually help us. We need to wait until Grolnok is already out before we can start milling our deck. You can run this as a budget deck, but the benefit you get is mostly from staples. This is largely a good stuff deck. This will probably work in low or battle cruiser for $150, and you can run this deck in mid power for $200 or more. I doubt it's viable in high power, but I may be wrong. I would be remiss if I didn't mention the use of Grolnok for a landfall deck. It's a bit of a stretch, and there are certainly better commanders, but Grolnok is excellent for combining landfall with Frog Tribal or Self Mill. Since you can play land cards and easily mill to get those cards, extra land playing cards are amazing, such as Azusa, Lost But Seeking, and Exploration, and of course the namesake landfall cards. These will give us a payoff for dumping out all these lands. Things like Avenger Zendikar, Lotus Cobra, and more will help make this deck go off. To jumpstart your brewing, there are some useful links and resources in the description. And here are some good cards in most Grolnok decks. Hedron Crab, Mesmeric Orb, and Hermit Druid will help us mill incredible amounts of cards. Azusa, Lost But Seeking will let us play extra lands per turn, and Deranged Assistant will mill us and give us mana. Laboratory Maniac effects are also incredibly powerful if we get to the bottom of our library. You can certainly build your deck to go straight to the bottom of your library and win with a Laboratory Maniac effect. Watch this video next to learn Scryfall syntax so you can learn how to make the type of searches I linked below. And subscribe, because I'm trying to reach 500 subscribers by 2022.